all in all, with the performance today, I know a lot of people thought this game would go the way it did, and but you got to go out and get it done. And your kids were all about business and getting, you know, making sure that they didn't let Melrose Maduro hang around in this ballgame.
Well, I thought that was key to come out ready to play right away, and I was very pleased with the effort. There's a lot of things you can take care of. One thing you can't always judge is how motivated your kids are. I thought our kids came out exceptionally ready to play today on both sides of the ball. I thought they were very focused and had that edge to them that you need to be successful. And I don't believe we're going to have any problem with that next week either.
No, not at all. You know, it's neat how kids do get motivated. You know, we've talked all season about being ready for the postseason. The postseason is here. They put up a good show, and now you get a chance to go up against a team that gave you probably your best battle of the year in the Cuba City Cubans. And do you relish the fact that Cuba's next on the schedule? I think if you know, those of us who looked at the brackets knew that they'd probably win last night. They're a good team that got, you know, sent north, and that meant a home game for them in the second round. Did you have all that figured out, and is this kind of playing out according to plan?
I guess I don't worry about where we play. You know, it's no different. It's nice not to have a long trip, which makes it not so terrible for our team. Going there, we're familiar with them. They're familiar with us. It's going to be about execution next week. Who can impose their will on the other team, and who can stop the big plays from happening? So we know them very well. They're very well coached over there. They're playing their best ball of the year. I believe their only loss in the last 5 weeks has been to us by one touchdown. So we better be ready to go next week, or we're going to find ourselves at home the rest of the season.
Scott, the way your defense is playing, though, it seems to come up big at the right time. And again, today, really very staunch and stubborn defensively. How good was the performance today, and how big will the defensive effort next week be?
Well, it's key to these games. As you get down further, you find that the team with the best defense usually goes an awful long way. This is by far one of the best defenses I've had since our state championship teams. It's a great mix of size and athletes. We don't really think of our athletes in the secondary and then in our linebackers, but they also what make us go here. They have the flexibility to play multiple positions. In fact, today we had Michael Roof, our defensive end, playing outside linebacker for us. So they have to be flexible, and depending upon what our opponent does, we put them in all different situations, and so far this year they've all handled it superbly.
And I think even on the offensive side of the ball, I think there's some aces that haven't been played very much this year that we saw glimpses of today with those tight ends and Cole McDonald throwing the football, when he had the wind at his back. Sometimes you can win games cookie cutter running the football, but you got to be happy with the potential that's there for your Darlington Redbirds.
Well, we have a potential to hit a home run in a lot of different areas. We have good size at our tight end position. Our wideouts run very well, and we can also take some of our backs from our backfield and split them out and cause some matchup problems. So we do have the capability. Obviously, we prefer to run the football because that's our bread and butter, and we want to wear you down, and that's what we do exceptionally well. Throw bodies at you and keep pounding on you. So hopefully they're big people, might be going both ways, and I can sub in, and then by the end of the game, we've got fresher legs than they have.
Well, we shall see. It's Darlington, Cuba City.